The WWE Championship is being contested in a fatal four-way match at WrestleMania.
You know, JR, these four guys have been at each other's throats for the past few months. The Rock won the Royal Rumble, but Big Show beat him at No Way Out for his title shot. And at the same event, Triple H sent Big Boney into retirement in a Hell in a Cell match.
That's right, King. It was looking like Mrs. Foley's baby boy fulfilling a lifelong dream tonight in the main event of WrestleMania, taking part in a match that is seemingly tailored for him, a fatal four-way.
There are no friends in this match, JR. It's all about the WWE Championship.
Before this match is over, I think we'll see shades of all three faces of Foley, as Mick has been known to leverage the more vicious aspects of his multiple personas when the need arises.
Cactus Jack, Dude Love, Mankind. Where does Mick Foley fit in amongst these radically different personalities? My bet is that deep down inside, he's all three people wrapped up in pain.
Especially when the Big Show is looking shaky out there. When you are that big a man, the target on your back is every bit as big as you are.
When you have three guys on you, wearing you down, teaming up on you, it's a perfect example of when size doesn't matter.
Especially when those three guys are Mick Foley, Triple H, and The Rock Foley, taking some damage out there. Has an incredible ability to withstand punishment that will leave a normal man broken.
Mick Foley doesn't know the meaning of the words "I quit."
He knows the meaning, King. He just won't say it. He would rather take a world-class beating than to say the words throughout this entire match. Triple H has tried to get each competitor to take each other out, to do his dirty work for him.
Play. I wouldn't be surprised to see.
The Rock is in a world of hurt, King, and now Mick Foley has come to get him some of the great one.
Triple H is directing traffic tonight. It looked like he's telling Mick Foley to do his dirty work.
Back into the ring now.
Kick. He used his opponent's momentum on that one. It is so hard stop that kind of strength. A counter.
Somehow, someway, the great one is still standing. But troubles.
Triple H is chipping away.
No, The Rock reverses it. Someone should have a search under the ring. There's weird things under there, I've heard.
And he's got a hold of that steel chair. These guys have just been relentless with these. How many more chair shots can they take?
This has gotten extremely physical.
The Rock with those steel steps in position as a weapon.
Triple H retaliates. The Rock is under that steel.
The Rock's getting assaulted.
It's down to The Rock and Triple H for the WWE Championship.
Oh, I think The Rock can feel it slipping away.
Somehow, some way, the great one is still standing. But trouble's knocking at his door.
Uh-oh. Look where he's going again.
Against all odds. Triple H is so smart, so devious, I'm sure he's got a great game plan. There is no way he walked in here without some kind of plan.
No, he's not called the game for nothing, JR.
Triple H is the ultimate student of the game. He always has a game plan, always has a way to walk out the champion. Ryback is in some serious trouble here tonight.
What would happen, JR? If it was Mick Foley and The Rock as the last two in the ring, I'd have to pick The Rock in that scenario.
One thing I've learned over the many years of calling matches ringside is to never, ever count out Mick Foley. The man is tougher than a $2 steak.
Yeah, but look at the break. The Rock is a third-generation superstar. Son of Rocky Johnson and Grant.
With devious intentions. And The Rock counters.
Oh, Triple H didn't see that coming. They are both laid out.
More are you willing to pay to win this match? This is unreal.
Back into the ring now.
Wow, those are some big shots from The Rock. Here's a cover.
McMahon's got the steel chair. He's going to hit Triple H. What? That was blatant.
Why did McMahon hit the Rock? He just cracked Rock's skull.
Could this be it?
Two.
Gets Brian.